Hi there, I'm going to do a little tutorial on calorimetry today. And so we'll start off with a quick review of what a calorimeter is. You have two nested coffee cups as one example, and you have one coffee cup inside of another one here, and that insulates the materials in the inside from the materials in the outside of the coffee cup. So you can put some chemicals into a solution on the inside part, and the reaction that will take place will heat up just the water and it won't escape outside, you see what it is. So in this question, I've got 4.24 grams of lithium chloride is going to be the chemical that we put in, and we're going to dissolve it into 100 mils of water inside the calorimeter. Once we do that, heat is liberated from the reaction, and the temperature of the water goes up. It starts at 16.3, and it goes up to 25.1 degrees Celsius. And I want to know what is the molar enthalpy of solution for lithium chloride. That means I want to know how much energy comes out of the reaction per mole of stuff that's added. Now, we're going to use the law of conservation of energy, and that says that the amount of heat gained by the water Q is going to be the same as all of the energy from the reaction, which is enthalpy delta H. And our formulas for Q, the heating of water, is VC delta T, is how you can calculate heat from temperature change of water, and the enthalpy of the reaction is the molar enthalpy times the number of moles. And so those two things we will equate and then solve the problem. So let's write down the data first that we have. 4.24 grams, that's for lithium chloride, and that's the mass. So 4.24 grams, and that is lithium chloride. Now for water, we have a volume given of 100 mils, that volume is therefore 0.1 liters. The heat capacity of water, look up in the tables, 4.19 kilojoules per liter degree Celsius. And the water's temperature changes from 16.3 degrees Celsius up to 25.1 degrees Celsius. So delta T is 25.1 minus 60.3, which is 8.8 degrees Celsius. So I will use this information to get Q. It's VC delta T, 0.1 liters times 4.19 kilojoules per liter degrees Celsius for water, and the temperature change of 8.8 degrees Celsius. Plug that into the calculator here, and we will get, once it's on, 0.1 times 4.19 times 8.8 gives us 3.69 kilojoules. Because our liters is cancelled, Celsius canceled. That's how much heat was given to the water. Now that is also the heat, therefore, we assume that comes out from the reaction. So that's our delta H. That's the enthalpy change for the reaction. That's almost what the question asked for, except it wanted the molar enthalpy. The molar enthalpy is H, not delta H. It's in kilojoules per mole. So you need to take what we have in kilojoules and divide it by the number of moles. But we get that from our initial information. 4.24 grams of lithium chloride, we just need to know how many moles that is. You can check a previous video of mine where we worked out how to get moles. It's mass divided by molar mass. We have 4.24 grams, and our molar mass we have to work out. Well, it is a lithium, which is 6.94 grams per mole, and a chloride, which is 35.45 grams per mole. So when we work this out, we get 4.29 divided by 42.4. So we take our and divide this out to the number of moles. So we have 4.29 divided by 6.94 plus 35.45. Working on it, you get 0.101 number of moles. Alright, so we're pretty much there to the end now. H is delta H divided by N, so kilojoules per mole. Our delta H was 3.69. We want to divide by the 0.101. This was kilojoules, that was moles. And so our H, we know it's going to be about 36.9. We'll work it out. So we take our 3.6872 divided by the answer we just received, and we get 36.43 kilojoules per mole. Okay, so to summarize how we got that answer, we found out the heat that the water gained, and we equated that to the heat that the reaction gave out. And by setting those equal to each other, we got to solve the question. That's what calorimetry is all about. Okay.